Let's say you have a polynomial equation that you want to solve. So let's take a look at one. Let's say you have 3x plus 5x plus 4 equals 9, and you want to solve this. So first of all, when we say solve a polynomial equation, what we really mean is solve for x. What is the value of x? And there's going to be one number that x is. By the way, if x is, there's no number here for x, no exponent, x is to the first, and there's going to be one answer. If x was squared, there would be two answers. So we're going to add these up. 3x plus 5x is 8x plus 4 equals 9. So what we did is step one, we combined like terms. 3x plus 5x is 8x. I didn't use these yet, so they drop straight down. Okay, now I want to get x alone. So I'm going to subtract 4 from both sides. 8x equals 5. And then now I'm going to divide both sides by 8 to give me x equals 5 eighths. So the example we just looked at was actually called a linear polynomial equation. It was linear because the x was to the first power. The exponent was 1. We call that linear. Let's take a look at a quadratic polynomial equation. Quadratic implies that the power is to the 2. The exponent is squared. So if we had x squared plus 5x plus 6 equals 0. And we want to solve this quadratic polynomial equation. Again, fancy words, quadratic just means squared. Polynomial means there's several terms. So if we want to solve this, we're saying what is x equal? What we're going to do is we're going to factor it to find out what values x could be. So how do we factor this? You can take a look at our other video on factoring to review that. But briefly, we want to know two numbers that multiply to be that and add to be this. So first of all, what times what is x squared? Obviously x and x, so that go here. Those two numbers, those two variables go there. The two things that multiply to be 6 could either be 1 and 6 or 2 and 3. And we want them to add, in this case, to be 5. So it's 2 and 3. 6 minus 1 would be 5, but because these are both plus, we're going to make them add. So that's a 2, that's a 3, they're both plus. So x plus 2 times x plus 3 equals 0, and x plus 2 times x plus 3 equals that quadratic. Now, what does x equal? Because this times this equals 0, we're going to set each of these equal to 0. Either this guy is 0 or that's 0, because 0 times anything would give us the 0. So solve these. We get x is negative 2. Solve this one. We get x is negative 3. So the two solutions for this quadratic polynomial are x equals negative 2, x equals negative 3.